Good morning and welcome to St. John's. I'm Zoe Waldridge, and today I will be your worship associate. As we gather, I invite you to be ready to light a candle or chalice of your own. St. John's is a church of the Unitarian Universalist tradition where all are welcome, regardless of race, class, age, gender or gender expression, political affiliation, or how much money is or isn't in your pocket. If you believe in no God, many gods, or one God, you are welcome here. We ask that those who join us respect the freedom and responsibility of faith, and that we support each other as we grow in spirit and work for justice. Today, we have a guest speaker, Reverend Sharon Dittmar, who will be sharing a sermon on adaptations to change. Very exciting. And a couple of announcements. You probably have noticed it at the bottom of your screen here. We now have closed captioning. Very exciting. They are auto-generated, so sometimes they might look a little bit different than, you know, what is said, but it's works out really well. We've had a really great time with it in our meetings so far. And if you want to turn it off, you're able to, at the bottom of your screen, click CC or live transcript button. Let's see here. Yep, it says live transcript. It has a CC button. You can click that and say hide. You can also go in and change your settings to make it bigger, whatever works best for you. The other announcement I have is that Reverend Mitra will be back in on Tuesday. So if you have been wanting to reach out to her, she will be around at that time. All right. And something that we wanted to do today, I happen to have a singing bowl. So we were going to start our service with just centering ourselves and listening to this. We light this chalice to celebrate Unitarian Universalism. Universalism, yeah. This is the church of the open mind. This is the church of the helping hands. This is the church of the loving heart. Together, we care for the church and for each other. We'll now move over to Marie for our shared affirmation.
Good morning. I am Marie Inanli, the co-director of religious life here at St. John's Unitarian Universalist Church. I welcome you to join in with me in stating our shared affirmation. This is the mission of our faith: to teach the fragile art of hospitality, to revere both the critical mind and the generous heart, to prove that diversity need not mean divisiveness, and to witness to all that we must hold the whole world in our hands. Thank you for joining in. So today, I'd like to try something different with our story for all ages. As Zoe mentioned, we have a guest minister who is delivering a recorded sermon about adapting to change. So we are going to change and invite you to participate in the story, because we're all part of the story that we create. So I'd like you to think a little bit about change, how you feel about it, how you respond to it. So I think many of us know that change, like death and taxes, as they say, is inevitable. But there's some change that many invite as positive, the birth of a baby, a new job, going off to school, many adventures. However, those positively perceived changes can also be bittersweet for the parents saying goodbye to their child going off, their adult child going off to school, whom they all miss dearly, to, oh, the lost sleep of a new baby and the conflicts between parenting and working that sometimes arise. So often what makes a difference is whether the change is expected or controlled or just throws us for a leap, like the tire that went bad when I was supposed to be leaving for my son's wedding, you know, oh, the timing. So I am going to launch a poll and I would like you to respond about how you feel when unexpected changes happen. Please note that your responses are anonymous. So I will be sharing the results. I think it's interesting because one of the learnings I have had with my own three children is that they are across the whole spectrum of feelings about change, from adventurous, gee, can I try eating insects? Truly, one of my children, and another one, oh my, let's keep the same brand of whatever we buy. So, wow. Okay, we will just have about 15 more seconds so you have an opportunity to participate. And I think just like some of the personality assessments that some employers do, that's a whole nother conversation, but knowing a little bit about how other people feel about change can help us be more considerate in dealing with each other. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. I am going to share the results. And it looks like many of you are curious about change. We understand that it can throw us for a loop, put us in a mood. Ugh, this isn't what I planned or expected. And then, oh, it looks very exactly the same. The people who feel like shutting down are excited. And then it appears that very few of us are unfazed. Okay, so I will stop that. That is how we feel about actually changes. But once we, you know, feel the feels, we have an option in how we respond to changes. So question, I'm going to escape this, is I'd like you to think about how you actually respond once a change occurs. Okay. It appears that we're having some technical difficulties. Thanks for your patience. I see a message here that someone doesn't see the poll. I don't know about what device you're on, but I know that sometimes on a tablet or a phone, you actually have to change the page to see polling or chat or whatever. So let me go ahead. All right. Well, we are going to just go ahead and stop with the feelings and just think among yourselves about how you act after you sit with your feelings for a little bit. And I would argue that one of the challenges of 2020 was that we had to deal with so many changes unexpectedly, unplanned for, and out of our control. So I invite all of us to think about being considerate. Okay, here we go. It's come up. Yay. So I do invite you to go ahead and we'll finish up with how we actually act after sitting with our feelings when we are confronted with change, particularly unexpected change, particularly change that is out of our control. And I hope thinking about this can help us be kinder and gentler with people who are wired or whose life differently or whose life experiences prompt them to have a different response to change. Because, you know, there are certain parts of our personality that are wired in and life experiences that may have made change either traumatic or exciting. So we have 5 more seconds and I will end the polling for your actual reactions. And I will share the results. Okay, it looks like, wow, 63% of us focus on the positive possibilities. Another significant portion, go on with life as close to normal as possible. There's comfort in that. Some of us grudgingly go on, so maybe we complain a little bit, but, you know, suck it up and move on. And then, there are some that get pumped with the adrenaline, embrace the excitement, and there are some that need to protect themselves and bail on the events. So I will stop sharing. And with that, I will close our unusual story for today. And I invite feedback, you know, by email or whatever, about how you feel about interacting with the story or whether you prefer to just receive it. Now I would like to introduce our song for today, which is a recording from our music director, Josh Dufford. If you would like to sing along on mute, of course, it is number 347, Gather the Spirit.